Yeah. So, hi again. My name is Marlen Verges. I'm working at the Fraunhofer Center for Chemical and Biotechnological Processes, and I'm about to give you a short presentation about the pilot scale FABIOLA lignin production and valorization. Yeah, and later on I hand over to my colleague Hugh, who's talking a bit about the base-catalyzed depolymerization of lignin. So, you probably heard about Fraunhofer already. We are one of the largest non-profit organizations for applied research in Europe. There are more than 70 institutes spread all over Germany and some international locations as well. There's more than 28,000 people working at Fraunhofer, and the funding is basically doing contract research for the industry or also in public funded research project. The special thing about our Fraunhofer CBP is that we are a piloting facility. So our aim is to close the gap between lab scale and industrial scale, with the main focus in the use of renewable resources and to make valuable materials out of that. We have equipment for all the different stages. So first of all, we have a pretreatment plant, different kinds of extraction facilities. Then we have the biotechnical technological department, who's working on different kind of fermentation. We've got our chemical department, who's working, they are working with different processes. And we also have the downstream processing at pilot scale that is often very important to be tested when you come from lab scale, because they're also often not used or tested. And one of our core competences is the organosol fractionation process. We have a pilot plant for this. So we're using different kind of lignocellulose. We used already different kind of hardwoods like beech or eucalyptus, but also softwood, spruce, or also wheat straw or miscanthus. And then we can apply different solvents. Usually we use ethanol for the organosol process and also small amounts of sulfuric acid. And we are aiming to all the major fractions in high quality for further applications. So, and with this process, we are involved in different projects. One of them that I want to present today is the Unravel project. That's the BBIGU project. And in this, we are scaling up the FABIOLA organosol process. This was invented by TNO, our project partners, and they are using acetone as a solvent for organosol fractionation. And it's working at relatively mild temperatures, so only at 140 degrees. And this leads to a less condensed lignin compared to other processes, and a really high sugar yield. And our aim in Unravel, we've got lots of nice partners, and together we are aiming to scale up a whole process chain to TRL 5. So this includes, first of all, the fractionation, FABIOLA fractionation, but also a pre-extraction step. And we are also looking into corrosion issues and the acetone mass balance to really prepare or do a techno-economic validation in the end. Yeah. Also downstream processing And yeah, also sugar and lignin product applications are regarded in the project. Here you can see a process flow diagram. So in Unravel, we're using different feedstocks. We started with clean birch and bark fraction, birch or beech fraction. But an aim of Unravel is to also use residual streams like bark or reed straw or even nutshells, or also to use a mix of these so that we can really simulate that a residual stream is used to be upgraded. And in a first step, we do an extraction process. This is one aim is to get high valuable extracts out of this. For example, betulin out of birch with bark. And yeah, this you could commercialize. But another aim is also to improve your feedstocks to prepare them for fractionation. So this work well. And then we do the fractionation process. It's the Fabiola acetone process. And yeah, our cellulose fraction is enzymatically hydrolyzed, and we have we test different fermentations process, for example, a fermentation to acetone. As an interesting chemical and also to make up for solvent losses in the process. And after fractionation, we also show the solvent recovery, and together with our lignin precipitation. The lignin in the end is also enzymatic depolymerized by our partners at Metgen, and there are different modifications and applications tested. And what's remaining here is our hemicellulose fraction, and we're doing a purification step, detoxification, usually with an activated carbon, to prepare our hemicellulose sugars for fermentation. And we have a process there for oxalonic acid production. And all of these processes we can scale up to TRL5 at our pilot plant here at CBP. So this is a picture of our organosolve pilot plant. It's basically based on a 400 liter fixed bed reactor where we fractionate the wood chips. It's ATEX rated, so we can use different solvents in here and do the fractionation process at first. Then we've got different plants for pulp washing and dewatering. In the end, we can also do the lignin precipitation and solvent recovery and concentrate our sugar samples to get to the syrups. So we can really and as this session was called challenges on lignin production, I wanted to give you some data about lignin precipitation approach, because that's often something in organosolve pulping that is not really regarded at lab scale. You can just add your water to the liquor, and you get your lignin quite easily filtrated. And that's what we also did in the first approach, that we just diluted our organosolve liquor and filtered lignin out of there. But we found out pretty soon that we had some issues here, because we couldn't get a high lignin recovery. And in the end, the plan in Unravel to scale up our patented lignisep precipitation method. This is it's a continuous evaporation of the solvent, So lignin is continuously precipitated in a special process, and it really enables the formation of a good filterable lignin, and we get much higher yield compared to the dilution approach. And also it was really challenging. I don't know if some of you worked in lab scale lignin already with temperature precipitation, but it's really hard sometimes to avoid lignin sticking all over the walls of your equipment. So this was quite challenging, but in the end, it really works pretty well that we get a high lignin yield, and we have a really robust process now. Yeah, and unravel lignin is tested in different application. First of all, it's used directly, and it's also there's also the depolymerization done in an enzymatic approach by Metgen, and then we also CNRS is also doing some modification, and in the end there's application tests going on for polyurethane isolation foams and also bitumen roofing materials. This is done by our partners at CNRS and Suprema. Yeah, and so far the results are quite promising here. And we're also having a look at our hemicellulose fraction. We found out that there's some soluble lignin still left in there, and we are looking for a process for detoxification and also to recover this remaining soluble lignin and also to detoxify the hemicellulose solution in the end so that we can go for the fermentation to xylonic acid. And with this, I would like to hand over to my colleague Björn, because he's working on another competence of ours, that's the base catalyzed depolymerization, and he's giving you a short view on that.
Yeah, hello everybody. Like Marlen said, I will present you some slides about our second core competence, the chemical conversion of lignin by base-catalyzed depolymerization. Yeah, here you see an overview of different thermochemical methods for lignin conversion. You can see the usual temperature range and the degree of product functionalization you get out of the process. The base catalyzed depolymerization is a hydrolysis reaction in a medium temperature range of 250 to 350 degrees and result in a medium to high degree of product functionalization. The process leads to the cleavage of the ether bonds in the lignin macromolecule, and as you see here, mainly the beta O4 ether bonds are cleaved. With the BCD reaction, products are liquid BCD oil fraction with low molecular weights phenolic compounds like guaiacol, catechol, syringol, and also some larger dimers. Also, oligomer BCD fraction is formed, and also some byproducts like organic acids, alcohols, and CO2. Yeah, we are working on the scale-up of the BCD of different types of lignin since 5 years. You can see a picture of our high-pressure pilot plant, which can be divided into an upstream part, a BCD reaction part, and a downstream part. At first, the lignin solution is mixed in a 300-liter mixing vessel. We mix lignin, sodium hydroxide as a solvent and catalyst, and with water. There we work in a concentration range of 5 to 10% lignin and 2 to 5% sodium hydroxide. After mixing, the alkaline lignin solution is compressed to 250 bar in a high pressure pump and pumped to the reaction plant with a flow weight of 5 to 20 kilograms per hour. Then the cold feed is preheated in such a double pipe heat exchanger with the hot reaction product mixture. And the final reaction temperature between 250 and 350 degrees Celsius is set in a second electrical heater. The residence time between 5 to 15 minutes is set is achieved by a plug flow reactor. After the reaction, the hot product is cooled down to 20 degrees and depressurized to 1 bar. The gaseous and liquid reaction products are separated, collected, and further purified. You see some yields and molecular weight distribution data of base-catalyzed craft lignin and organosalt lignin. For craft lignin, typical yields are 60 to 75% oligomers and 5 to 15% monomers or oil. Yeah, depending on the process conditions, the molecular mass of the lignin can be significantly reduced to a white average mass, which you can see here, between 1,200 and 2,800 gram per mole. And the number average white molecular weight between 480 and 950. Gram per mole. For organosolv lignin, typical yields are 70 to 85% for beech and also in the range for pine wood organosolv lignin. Typical monomer yields are 5 to 10%. And here you see the molecular weight distribution data. They are there's a little bit lower compared to craft lignin. Goes from 1,100 to 2,600 gram per mole, and for the numbers, 400 to 900 gram per mole. Yeah, the reduced molecular weights and the higher number of free phenolic bonds significantly increases the reactivity of the of the BCD oligomers compared to the starting lignin, for example, 20 to 50% higher amount of phenol can be replaced in such phenol formaldehyde hard resins by BCD oligomers. Yeah, thank you for your kind attention, and feel free to contact my colleagues Marlen, Kerstin, or me at any time if you have any questions or project collaborations.